Hi, it's Sonia, and welcome back to my art YouTube channel. I'm back with a real-time process video from my, I guess I'm going to call this one my sort of loose sketchbook, and it is I really like this piece. I'm pleased with it. It is a sort of a still life where I combine two reference photos. And I've, I tried to keep to sort of a more limited palette and used one material, one medium on it, which is Turner's acrylic gouache. So what I thought I'd do in this video, it's about 24 minutes long. I've edited it a little bit because it's one of these pieces that I was doing while uploading a video. So I took some breaks in between to faff around on my computer. So yeah, there's a little, I've only edited it a bit, but in general, this sort of sketch takes me about half an hour. And I thought to begin the video, I would describe a bit of my process with this piece. And then the middle section, I thought I'd use as an opportunity to answer another question from you guys, which is great. And then at the end, I'll like sum up the final bit of the process and end. That's my plan. Okay, so yeah, this piece is on, it's an Artesia mixed media sketchbook, and I had this one, I've just got it next to me now. It's got a lot of pre-painted pages actually that I've done ahead. So I've used up old gouache or paints, which I know I've talked about many, many times, because I really find having a block colour background is such a great way to get going on a piece. And then in the past, I've painted on white paper, and then I want a blue background, and you're having to go around with your paintbrush and go into all the nooks and crannies, so basically pre-preparing is the way I'm trying to go at the moment with these sort of more colourful, loose, still life paint pieces. And then you saw me maybe, I hope you're drawing along with me, so maybe, you didn't see me, but what I did do, I can tell you, is I drew a very loose outline for this sketch, like a guide, with a Prismacolor pencil. And I've got the photos, it's of an old house plant on my Mac. And I just thought, it's sadly no longer with me, but I thought I'd draw this house plant on the right, and then I was like, I'll mix it in with another photo reference of a vase of flowers. Because when you do get vases, when you get flowers, I really like to both draw them from life and then take a picture, and then you've also got a photo of them as well to use at a later date. And then the other thing you can do is use your sketches, I know a lot of artists do as well, sketch from the sketches of the flowers. So I feel like you get good, good use out of them, especially if you're treating yourself to flowers. And so that's the composition. It's basically just two items. And then I am painting, as you can see now, I use Turner's acrylic gouache for this. Because I just thought on this background, I couldn't remember if it was a gouache or acrylic background. So, and I decided for speed, and just partially I was in the mood for blues. So I basically used the colours straight out of the tubes. I think I mixed a couple of them together to see what I would get. But I've kept this to a mainly blue piece apart from right at the end, and I can discuss that again when we get towards the ending of this video. So yes, I try and keep it loose. I feel like maybe using the smaller brush, it does gets a little bit detailed at times, but and there's quite a loose rendition. I should have actually maybe shown some of the photos that I sketched from. So I've kind of made it, you can see it's from the reference, but I also don't feel that you have to, especially if you want loose work, copy a photo. In actual fact, play around with putting a leaf where you want a leaf to go, or leaving out, simplifying. Don't, if it's a really busy pot plant and you don't want to be painting 20 leaves, just draw in 8 or however you want to play it. So that's another tip for simplifying. Sorry, I'm going to have to cough. simplifying pieces. Then you'll see me do the other vase as well. As I said, this is a real-time process video, so I think this is a sort of a more slower painting. In this fashion, it tends to be a bit more of a slower process for me as well, whereas I think the other sketchbook I would have been sharing, the altered sketchbook, I could do fill up a spread in like 10 minutes with those, because I'm using collage as well. Something I need to bear in mind, and I'm just thinking out loud, is not to get too precious in this sketchbook, because it is tempting, because it is good, it feels like nice quality, nice quality paper, and you know, even these sort of like block pages look so pristine. But I need to try and bring in some of my work processes from that altered sketchbook and not be afraid to mix up the media. So I will share how I get on along the way. Okay, so now I thought I would go into answering a question from, I've written it down, from Christina. In the future when I make these videos, I might do some silent ones and some with music. So for any of you who don't want to listen to me waffle on, but I don't know, I'm always interested in artists' life, in their sort of how they got into it. So I thought maybe this is a good question to answer. So the first question was, how has my art journey started and developed? So, and again, I want you guys to maybe also reflect on some of these questions for yourself as well, because I think that's a really useful exercise, especially at this kind of, I don't know, this year feels like it's flown past. And I think we should like celebrate all the gains and the even baby steps that we have made over time. And I don't know again if this is like a lot of you guys, but I was, and I think I discussed it briefly in the other video, I've been into art since I was a kid. A lot of my childhood memories are colouring, the joy of colouring with my pens lying on the floor, drawing with my, I had like a very sort of creative grandma who basically I spent a lot of time with, and we did a lot of art together, like drawing and painting. In particular, like drawing, my whole drawing people sort of came about because I remember I wanted to be a fashion designer when I was little, but I was terrible with sewing. But I used to, with my grandma, like play this game where we draw makeup fashion figures, and yeah, my dad had to like judge them. So I've got some good memories of making art when I was younger and being into it. And then at school, I was just, I don't know if it's because I practiced or I was drawn to it, but I did quite well in some of the art competitions. Like I made it to some county competition. I didn't actually go, but they sent my work, and it was like a pheasant's, I remember drawing a pheasant's wing, and it took me hours to draw this pheasant's wing in pencil. But I think we can all, if we think back to our childhood, I mean, maybe there was glimmers of why we are into what we are now, and I can definitely see that art has always been there for me. And also in terms of like one side of my family, you know, I had great uncles and a great grandfather who were all, you know, good, great draftsmen, and a great uncle who was actually a fashion designer before he went bust. I think it's there in different ways, very different to me though. Something to, I'm quite aware of is like my brother and my dad, that they like model making like these intricate, really cool models. And I feel like they're a lot of, I don't know if people have this with their family and friends, like, but you may have family members who are really into art styles that are very different to your own. And I think one of the things to mention, because I think this happens to a lot of us, is when you're a kid, you do feel, I felt like sometimes pressure to draw, you want to please people, so you end up drawing. If you get good feedback on something, and maybe this is in the modern world as well with social media, we have to be careful of, like, if we start to do art that pleases people and we get a lot of positive validation from it, and I definitely was one of those kids who enjoyed, like, you know, sort of getting validation and doing well, then there is the tendency to carry on. So I do feel, I also went through that stage, and I see it in my kids as well, where, again, being able to draw realistically is really is something that people seem to admire, because a lot of time people struggle with learning to draw. And so if you see someone who makes it, who can do it, you get, often you're like, oh wow, that's such an incredible, you know, drawing of a lion in detail. So I think I ended up, I don't even think I knew about loose, knowing about the Impressionists, but I didn't know as much now about all these other people doing abstract work and sort of lesser known people as well, which I think is the joy of, well, one of the positives of an online life, that you don't, you get to know about the sort of not so famous artists, or other artists who aren't in galleries, outsider artists, can actually be more, not insider artists, what's the word, but more like people can see their work now, which is, I think, a great thing. So yeah, I did, and then I did do GCSE art. I think I wanted to do, there was part of me, because I really wanted to do art. I was thinking about it, but like from my mum's side, and I totally understand this, there was a lot of, but maybe I think through worry for me, resistance, and you know, sometimes I'm kind of grateful because I'm totally cool with how everything's panned out. But I think, yeah, she did say that she was worried about, like, if I was spending too much time on art and wanted me to understandably, like, make sure that I got through school and did well in academic subjects. And so I ended up, and I also went to quite sort of an academic, my school was, wasn't particularly an artsy school. So I ended up, thinking I'd go for medicine. And if I didn't get in, I'd also go for, like, to try and do a BTEC at my local art college. And I think everyone was worried, like, well, what are you going to do if you do art? What are you going to do? And I was like, well, maybe I'll be an art teacher. I wasn't trying to be, you know, over ambitious with it. Or, and that back then, when I was like in the late 80s, early 90s, I just don't think we knew, especially the school, like all these different career options from art. It was, I think people just thought, oh no, if you go to art school, or I think from my mum, you could just come out and end up, what are you going to do? You might just be a penny, you know, how are you going to earn money? And which is, I totally understand that, you know, I can empathise with that thinking. So yeah, I went for, so in the end, I did get into I went into medicine and I went with that. And because I was also motivated with to be a, I thought it'd be good to be, you know, obviously I wanted to be a doctor and help, I think I wanted to both help people, and it was obviously a very secure, it seemed like a secure line of work, and I was all right at sciences, I wasn't bad at sciences. So yeah, I ended up at medical school for 6 years. I met my husband, we studied together in London, and I, to be honest, I had a great, I enjoyed that part of my life. I think the variety, I don't need to be self-diagnosed, but I have, I do need variety. So I think the great thing about medicine was we were doing so many different subjects. I was, again, never bored at medical school. The thing that did happen, and why this is relevant to art, is as soon as I went to study medicine, I couldn't keep up. I stopped really making art. I think I was focused. I worked really hard, and I'm not one of these naturally, what's the word? I can't just read a page and memorize it. I have to work hard to do well in exams. So I really focused on my studies, and I only did, I think I did, one year I did do, a friend of mine was doing like an art, what's it called, an English A-level on the side, and I was like, oh, I've got a bit more time, I think it was in my BSc year, I'll go and do a watercolour class in Balham, so I just did a watercolour class, which was lovely, and then I also managed to get a unit of drawing at the Slade, actually, they counted that towards my BSc, so that was an amazing opportunity. And I've got to be honest, I remember going into the drawing classes there and being really jealous that people got to do this like for 3 years full time, but I was grateful to have that experience. And I also went to lots of art galleries there for free in London, which is amazing. So I would go and visit art galleries, and in that way I think I tried to sustain myself with art. After medical school, in my junior doctor year, I chose to do psychiatry, and I, looking back, I wonder if that's because it is more of a creative, as it were, branch of medicine, and a lot of the people in psychiatry are very kind of into the arts, like the theatre, and I loved, also I was really, I'm also really interested in psychology and, you know, mental health, so I went and worked in, stayed in London and did all my undergraduate exam, postgraduate exams as well, and membership. So yeah, because I was really focused, I didn't do any art then, to be honest with you. So I was sort of sketching, maybe when I'd go away with my husband, occasionally I'd take a sketchbook and I'd do little sketches, but I feel like I lost art from my life in a practical sense, or my own creativity. I lost that for like, when I was sort of 18 to till I had the till my oldest kid. I think actually, okay, I'm going to be really honest with you. When I was about, so this is kind of personal, when I was about to turn 30, my late 20s, I've been struggling to actually have kids. And I think I was having like a really, really early midlife crisis. I was also really burnt out in psychiatry in London. Just the jobs were changing. It was hard to get a job. And yeah, I'd just been studying. I think I was thinking, I actually decided to sort of take a sabbatical and go back and do a pre-foundation art course a year. And then I was thinking, like, could I, in the future, if I wasn't going to have kids, that wasn't my life, maybe I'd try and do a part-time art degree and then maybe just be a staff grade doctor, because I thought that would sort of lessen, as it were, the sort of stress of the job and risk of burning out. But then I did manage to have, I had my eldest son, and then 18 months later, it was a quite short age gap between them, my second son, and I was fortunate, I chose to stay at home with them, and I was a bit optimistic. I don't know if any of you guys are like this. I thought, maybe when I've had, having a baby at home, I'll have, or kids, young kids at home, I'll have more time than I did in my medical career, because I was so focused on keeping up to date with journals and audits and everything. To do some art on the side, but that did not transpire. That was full on. I've bringing up young kids, it's super, I was just really tired. I just sketched them occasionally when they were having naps themselves, because drawing them moving around was very frustrating. So then when it changed for me, and this is when I got back into art in a really big way, I would say, was when we moved to Switzerland. We followed my husband, like, had a job opportunity, so we went over there to Basel, and my youngest was only 3 months, and I think it was such a big change in lifestyle and being more isolated in some ways, like not having friends and families and all the regular play drop-in toddler groups that I had had in London. And the other thing to say is I did get my first iPhone, and I could, like, I did sign up for Instagram. I was like, okay, I'm going to actually make art more of a priority now. I think having also a sort of a traumatic birth with him, having an emergency C-section and preeclampsia, made me a bit more focused on also doing the things I wanted to do, not waiting for the perfect time. So I started doing it I've written also some blog posts as well I've contributed to. I wrote about doing a daily, being accountable, signing up to show my work on Instagram every day, and just doing a daily sketch. And back then I was doing mostly gouache. I got into gouache sketches because we were like renting a place, so I'd be working a lot of the time on the kitchen table or the bedroom table while I was having a nap. So I just needed small, portable, easy to clean up art supplies. And I found that that's when I learned the real joy of sketchbooks and, sort of just playing around with gouache paints as well. I got it into it in a big way. And through being on Instagram, I got quite a few opportunities I sort of met people online, more so than I was able to in Switzerland, to be honest. I didn't really make any art friends in Switzerland. I had mum friends, but not art friends as such. So it was a great way of connecting with other artists. And I got some opportunities to occasionally do a couple of small, tiny illustration gigs, writing blog posts, I think wrote a section for my friend's book, The Motherhood of Art by Marissa Huber. And what else did I? Yeah, so no, it was great. I really enjoyed that, and that takes me to, so yeah, I kept that going. As I think it got a bit more challenging actually. I had a few sort of poor years where, not poor years, but years of lower productivity when he actually became older, and you know, when they drop their naps, when I lost his nap time, that then it became much more of a struggle to draw when he was still home with me all the time. But I got into doodling then, so that helped me get into doodling. And then moving out here, we moved out here about over, gosh, around 7 years ago. And it takes time to settle, obviously, but I have been, I think because of that whole daily, the thing that worked for me was that daily drawing project back in 2015. It's like I got back into a habit again, which is actually why I've made the effort to try and upload videos here, just to say, almost daily to start with, because there's something about a 30-day habit, doing something every day consistently as you can. Really, just it just sort of gets it into your brain that that's what you're going to be doing at some point in your day. So yeah, so then I've been since I've come out here, I really feel things have I've grown a lot. I feel like if you look back at my sketchbooks, and I've shared a lot of them from 2015 to now, I think you can see that I have changed, probably both as a person in some ways, and because I think we do develop all the time, and as an artist. I'm coming up to the end of this video, so maybe I'll make this. I can talk more because I think another question you asked, Christina, was how your style and interests have changed over time. So I think I'll maybe delve into that in another video. I do want to wrap this up. So yeah, here you can see I'm now wanted to go in. I'm going to go in with some red paint for the roots that were coming up, and I think this was slightly maybe a bit of a darkness in me, like exploring that dark side with, you know, things that when sometimes it feels like in really dark times, we but just needing sort of like the color of blood and the roots sort of coming out. So that's how I end up this piece. I finished this piece off, and I do think that's been it was an effective color choice for that part. But no, overall I was pleased with this spread, and it was super relaxing and fun to do. So it's making me looking at it now. I just want to go and do another one. Okay, thank you for watching this video. As always, thank you for if you're liking and subscribing. Also, just to let you know, I do have a Patreon membership that I have just recently launched. Thank you to Becky for like being my first member there. I'm hoping to make that a bit more of somewhere where I can open up more personally about art, with the aim of sharing and encouraging others. So and looking at what that site offers in terms of maybe sharing more tips or even teaching and different things, but I need to investigate that a bit more. But I will be sharing some more behind the scenes posts there. Okay, are we nearly? Yeah, I'm going to say goodbye, and yeah, thanks for watching, because this video is going to end in 10 seconds. I have to keep an eye out for this, otherwise, it takes me ages. I have to keep re-editing. All right then. Bye. See you next time.